fun. So tonight I'm going to be looking into Azure. I wanted to use a TTS service, but the problem is it costs money. And as a private developer, somebody who's just making this on my own time, this being GIFBot, I didn't want to take the brunt of that. And so what I'm going to do is set up TTS and get it running using the Azure Cognitive Services and Speech. Cognitive Speech Service, sorry. Okay, I've already set up TTS to kind of function, with the exception of not actually doing the actual TTS portion. The Azure website has a portal that you access to add services. And what I'm gonna do is I'm in my portal, I'm looking through. So I go to Cognitive Services, embed the ability to see, hear, speak, et cetera, et cetera. Create a cognitive service. It's called Speech. Let's see here, Speech, okay. Will this do text to speech? Oh yes, convert text to audio nearly in real time. Okay, so I'm gonna create that. I'm gonna move that off of the screen. I named it GIFBot TTS. This is gonna be my service. You know, it's my subscription there. I selected that. I am in Central US, so I'm gonna set it to that region. Free tier, please, and thank you. And I just created a resource group. So I'm gonna pop this back over here and create that. It looks like the deployment's in progress. So we're gonna let that kind of do its thing. Configuration wise, this is a tutorial that I'm following and it legit has all the stuff that I need in it already. I just want to stream it to a file. I don't care about it being in memory because it needs to be accessible from the web and loaded from the web. And so I'm gonna save it to a temporary file that's gonna be like a random GUID that I create that goes with the request and create that file and then immediately turn around and delete it when I'm done with it. So it won't build up because the requests, they basically end up getting queued up. So you can't guarantee like have this one file that you overwrite and write to all of the time. It's just not gonna work. You know, I probably need to add the service to this. Dependencies, manage my NuGet packages. Microsoft.cognitive services. There we go. I'm going to install that. Hopefully this gives me everything that I need. So we're gonna do speech config dot using from subscription. Now, I temporarily hard coded my subscription key. I just threw it in there temporarily. This is not where it will stay forever. I don't like to use var. And the reason I don't like to use var for some things is because I don't know what kind of object I'm working with. So I'm actually going to change that. This is interesting. Using audio config equals audio config dot from wave file output test.wave. So we'll just do that using speech synthesizer equal to new speech synthesizer. And then I pass it that config, the config plus the audio config. Await synthesizer dot speak text async. This is just a test of the emergency broadcast system. I'm gonna temporarily make this public and I'm gonna go into GIFBot and I'm gonna hijack a button. I just don't know what I wanna hijack. I need to steal. I'll go into the hub for GIFBot, GIFBot hub. Play animation, this is the one I usually hijack. So I will just do KC. Bot dot or share manager dot, there we go. I think that was it. Yeah, that's the method I made. TTS volumes fava blount. Put a breakpoint in here and just make sure that we can get into this point. If I can get this configuration with my sub ID and the region that I created, then we should be good. Okay, my deployment is complete. So if I go to my resource, it looks like it's up and running. I don't think I need to do anything else with it because I just pass it my ID and region. Let's start it. God, I hope it builds. No, it didn't build. Oh, that's so weird. I know I refactored it when I did it. Huh. Okay, so this is the baby Yoda, or it was the baby Yoda. Wait, why didn't you play? Oh, I hijacked that button. I'm so sorry, I hijacked the button. Okay, so it connected. There's the audio config and it returns. So I'm gonna hit play through.
I always sneeze on my knuckles before a fight to inflict extra poison damage.
Wait, what? Oh my God, wait, the code actually goes through? No, 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 wait a second. Where is it playing it? I didn't tell it to play. Did you guys hear that? Wait a second, what happened? It played this, but how? Because I'm using Google TTS and it doesn't work in... No, I'm just like, wait a second. So this worked. I don't know how. So here's the thing is, in Chrome, there is a way to invoke TTS. It doesn't always work, especially in Chromium. So that's why I wanted to use Azure, because they have a more sophisticated system. Clearly, it didn't take much time for it to come back with this information. So I probably should grab that result. So let's do speech synthesis result. Speech synthesis result is equal to, let's Google what this does. It presents the synthesized audio in the result. Properties of the result, the reason, result ID, which is a string. So we're gonna put a breakpoint right here, and it won't fall out of scope because I'll just step over. So we'll break here and we're gonna do F10. And what's in the result? Canceled. Why was it canceled? Maybe there's something I didn't do in the portal. These keys are used to access your cognitive service API. Good. Store them securely, for example, using Azure Key Vault. We also recommend regenerating these keys regularly. I'm not sure if the subscription key is the GUID that's assigned to my subscription account, or if it's the key that's on the resource. Both keys do the same thing. One is a backup. Use the key with the endpoint. Key with the endpoint. Yeah, because the endpoint is a token. It's issuing a token. So I have this feeling that's not going to do what we want it to do. Okay, I'm gonna bring the bot over. So if you guys haven't seen GIFBot, the TTS option is going to be for the regurgitator, but people will need to learn how to create an Azure account and use that. So I'm just trying to get this TTS functionality kind of like started and experimenting with Azure service tonight. All right, let's see. We're gonna hit F10 to step over. It did it. Okay, so I'm gonna shut this off. This file, let's open it up.
This is just a test of the emergency broadcast system.
Fantastic. Okay, so this worked. I'm so shocked when that happens. This is our request. Force a TTS request. I don't want to do these. What I want to do instead is to create a temporary animation data. And that should work. So we have an entry. GUID TTS ID is equal to GUID.new GUID. Okay, so that will be the identifier I use for the animation. So animation data, TTS animation data is equal to new. TTS will be the name of it. This is not gonna be stored anywhere. So I'm just gonna send it up and play it and stop. Let's initialize it this way. All right, TTS animation data. This is what I wanna do is I wanna create this temporary animation data object to kind of just hold that information and push it up. But the thing is like, I usually tell it to stop playing an animation, but I don't tell it to stop playing the audio. Audio is equal to TTS ID dot wave. Why is it auto for? Stop auto formatting it. I don't want you to do that. Volume. Okay, there's gotta be a way that I can get the length of the file. The result has how many bytes were written, but it doesn't tell me what the duration is. If I don't set an accurate duration on the WAV file that's pumped up to the animation, then there's an opportunity for it to get stomped on if there's another animation queued behind it. For now, we'll set it to like 5,000 milliseconds. So there's the result. Instead of forcing a TTS request, we'll do bot.animationManager.force queue animation, and we're going to do anim Mr. Smoofy, pass a empty trigger name because I don't care who triggered it. So what that's going to do is that's going to go through and it's going to force queue it here and add the animation to the here. Yeah, I think that's really all I needed. I will eventually need to have the time on it. Let me just make sure this is the right way to do it. Is I push it up to a Blazor front end. I have that do a JavaScript interrupt to play the sound. But the thing is, there is a queue that is tightly controlled by the server that's running in ASP.NET, ASP.NET Core specifically. Another animation could get put in behind it and then played. So if the duration of the WAV file is actually like closer to like 10 seconds, it'll sit there and play the next one because the sounds don't auto stop. So I have to be cognizant of that. So when I send it up, it has to have accurate timing. Otherwise, it overwrites because the browser doesn't have an idea of audio threads. If you tell JavaScript, play this audio, and then you turn around and say, play this audio too, it'll stop. Okay, so we send the start of the animation. This sends it here. So here's the send for the TTS message. That starts a timer and this tells it to stop. That's why there's somewhat of a delay, by the way, if there's a bigger visual, because I have to drive it through here. If I trust the client to kill it, then if you're switching scenes or something, you'll get stuck in a state where GIFBot is constantly running the same animation because it never got told to stop. I need to know when it's ready to stop. In here, when I go to deactivate the animation, animation data, animation command. Deactivate animation, try remove, command, animation request removed. Okay, so the command name needs to be a GUID. So when I put this in, instead of naming it that, I need to name it by the GUID. I wanna say I had a TTS request, and it's a request base, audio file. Basically, I'm talking to Azure now and retrieving this information to write to a file that I can then play in the browser real fast. This is my first time using this, and so this chunk of code here is probably going to go into a helper class at some point, so I don't have it hard-coded in this one spot, but I wanted to get something up and running and working tonight. So I'm kind of like working in this tiny little area just to get things going. Force queue animation. I send it the data, but I need a way of tagging it. Let's do animation. If animation is not equal to null, then animation request is equal to new animation request, animation string dot empty, true, false. We're gonna create an enum. Okay, so let's go to animation enums. Yes, public enum request type animation and TTS. The type of request for an animation when it is queued. It determines how it is treated once it has finished playing. Public request type animation enums dot request type animation by default. Okay, so what this is going to allow me to do is identify the request so that I know how to treat it on the returning end. I'm going to do force queue TTS request, which is going to take this animation data and it is going to generate this request. I'm going to set the request type equal to the TTS type so I can check against this when it's done playing and clean up the file I created, because I don't need to do like stop, get rid of the animation from the queue, all that stuff. I just need to kill it with fire. So what this is gonna do is create the animation. The other thing I need to look at was where to shove the file, because right now I'm putting it in a place that the web end is not gonna be able to find. Let's look at our controllers, because I have the upload controller. And that should be putting files where it's supposed to go. Animation data import. There we go, that's where it's supposed to go. Now we'll queue a TTS request that goes in here. Once it's played, we start the animation timer. It'll try to remove it from the active animations. That should be fine because I name it by the GUID. The command name is a GUID. That's gonna be like, if somebody can guess a GUID, go for it. If animation request, that request type is equal to TTS. This was a generated TTS alert. Delete the TTS audio file. And that would be animation request dot animation data dot audio string audio path. Audio path file dot delete audio path. And that'll be it, because the animation request and that animation data was all temporary and it should fall out of scope because nothing will be referencing it after it does this. I am so curious to see if this works. I wish I could check the result a little better. Otherwise, if it fails, it's just gonna start racking up all these files. I'm gonna hit this breakpoint here anyway. So I'll look at that and I'll see like what information we're getting back from it. It might give me the duration in the results. Let's just see what happens. Okay, 10, there's the result. What do we get back from it? Here's the properties. There's absolutely nothing in there that's helpful. The audio data is just bytes. I can probably figure it out. I bet you it's in the properties. F11, active animations. There's only the one. Interesting. It didn't play it. Huh. Regurgitator data loaded. Let's try it again. Uh-huh.
A guy that's really bad at limbo walked into a bar.
No, it works. It works. I just had it paused. Okay, so I'm gonna go into our dev folder here. Server, well, that's where the settings are, client, root. Let's go to our details view and do date. I'll sort it by date. What I wanna do is I wanna watch this.
Hard work will never hurt you as long as you watch it from a safe distance.
I'm shutting the bot down. Okay, so it's working. Okay, well, that's basically it. So now the real crux of the problem is ensuring that we get the right duration. You would think it would pass back this information to let me know, but I guess not. Can I synthesize straight to speak text async? Oh, I might be able to do this right here and not have to put it through the system at all, which means it would play through the speakers, which does understand. Speak text async. Oh, do that, but don't do the audio config. If I just do this section like that, just with the configuration file, and don't tell it I want to write it out, then it should just speak the results. But mind you, this is from ASP.NET Core. It might not understand desktop audio, but we'll see if this works. So GIFBot is hosted on the user's computer. As much as I would love to host it on a website somewhere, I can't because of the nature of the files. I thought about, well, I could put GIFBot Lite up somewhere, but it would limit people in the size of the animations. They wouldn't be able to do half of the crazy stuff that they want to do with it. So it just seems silly. Okay, so we've made it down here.
My therapist told me my narcissism causes me to misread social situations, but I'm pretty sure she was hitting on me.
I am in love. I don't even have to do this. I can't believe that actually worked. I love it. Okay, so that now works. Wow. I may pick this up again tomorrow.